Good morning, and welcome to the graduation ceremony for the O'Fallon Township High School District 203, Class of 2020. I am Dr. Darcy Benway, Superintendent of District 203, and it is my pleasure to share in this celebratory event with you today. To start off the 2020 graduation ceremony, let us honor our country. Ladies and gentlemen, the national anthem of the United States of America, as sung by senior student and 2020 graduate, Hannah Binion.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Thank you, Hannah. It is now time to honor and celebrate the class of 2020. Graduates, you did it! Although your O'Fallon Township High School journey is coming to an end, today also marks the beginning, the starting point of your next endeavor. This is the beginning of your journey to your next great accomplishment. Before you leave OTHS and begin that journey, I would like to share a few thoughts with you. Thoughts that were shared with me as I was growing up. My father often tried to convey his wisdom through numerous quotes. He would say these quotes over and over to me as I was growing up. Today I hear some of his words ringing in my ears, and now as I share them with you, those words have taken on a new and even deeper meaning. My father's favorite quote was from a song written by John Lennon of the Beatles. He would say, "Life is what happens to you while you are busy making other plans." I didn't understand that at first when I heard it. I didn't get it. But listen to those words. Life is what happens to you while you are busy making other plans. I really can't think of a better quote to describe and sum up the last 10 weeks. I truly believe life happened to us as we were all making other plans for the school year, for competitions, for athletic events, for activities, for dances, for celebratory events, and yes, plans for walking across the stage in the OTHS Panther Dome before family and friends to celebrate your graduation. Life happened to all of us this past 10 weeks while we were busy making other plans for something that we believed would look quite different. Class of 2020, this will not be the last time that life happens to you while you're making other plans. Class of 2020, you will be prepared for it when it does happen, though. You will be prepared because you are armed with your OTHS education, the best education around. You will also be prepared as a result of your newfound resilience that you've acquired from recent life experiences that were thrown your way during this final semester of school. As I said before, graduates, you did it. You completed high school and overcame adversities that no other graduating class in recent history has had to face. I must admit that my father also was a fan of Winston Churchill, and he would share Winston Churchill's favorite quote, "Success is never final, Failure is never fatal. It's courage that counts. I share these words with you, class of 2020, because they are so very true and they are words to live by. I hope you take this moment with me to reflect on those words. Today you are a success, a high school graduate. Congratulations. You have overcome obstacles to get here. But that success is not final. It's not done. Success is rather a building block for your future successes. Likewise, failure's never fatal. You will not die from failure. In fact, failure is a part of success. Learning from your mistakes or failures is a part of growing up and moving forward. Don't be afraid to try. Class of 2020, don't be afraid to jump in with both feet. Don't be afraid to fail. Failure is never fatal. At the end of the day, what matters most will be your courage. The courage to continue the efforts and the hard work that it takes to be successful, and the courage to rise above any failures, adversities, or obstacles that you may face in your life. So remember, success is never final. Failure is never fatal. It will be your courage that counts. Graduates, we are all so very proud of you. I can't wait to see the amazing things the class of 2020 is going to do. You are, and you always will be, Panther strong. Congratulations, graduates. At this time, it is my pleasure to introduce your class president, Braden Gabe. He is here to share some thoughts and reflections for the class of 2020. Braden.
Good morning, parents, family, friends, and fellow classmates. Thank you for joining us today. First off, on behalf of the entire class, I would like to thank the school officials and tech teams for putting all this together and creating a unique and memorable graduation under very challenging and difficult circumstances. Our graduation is certainly nothing like we imagined. However, thank you for working to make it special. When I think of the class of 2020, one word that always comes to mind is resilience. You name it, we've been through it. We lived through the Milburn fire of 2016, several boil orders, incredible ice storms, power outages, faulty fire alarms, and really awful music at our homecomings. Our class's story is truly exceptional. When we were born, we entered into a frightened and uncertain world around 9/11. And here we are again in uncertain times. In 2016, this misfit bunch of O'Fallonites, Shiloh kids, military brats, and many others came together to take on high school and the world. Over the next 4 years, we went from the awkward and annoying freshman class to one of the most memorable classes of OTHS. I'm so proud to be a part of this amazing class of 2020. How amazing is this class? Well, let me tell you. As a class, we earned millions of dollars in scholarship money. 16% of our class is in the top 10% of all seniors in the state of Illinois and recognized as Illinois State Scholars. 140 members of our class were IHSA Scholastic Achievement Award honorees, meaning we have 140 stud student-athletes. 180 students are active members of the National Honor Society. This class also has 12 National Merit Committed students, to include a National Merit Finalist. We have students going to prestigious colleges and universities around the country within the Ivy League, Big Ten, and SEC, just to name a few. Our journey had many highs. Our class has rallied to improve school spirit by increasing participation in sporting and school events, which included one of the greatest comebacks in history for the Spirit Stick. Also, for the first time in history, we had a state title, thanks to girls bowling. One of our best achievements is we had the most participated and well-executed senior skip day in history. We really overdid it on that one, guys. This is normally where I would let the laughter die down, but unfortunately I don't have a sizable audience, and I'm not that funny. But looking back on these 4 years, our class has truly accomplished some remarkable things. But like most things in life, you can't have peaks without valleys. And our class has experienced those low points as well. This year, one of our own classmates, Dante Mercado, passed away. Dante was brilliantly smart and was always true to himself. Although he was shy at first, he was thoughtful and charismatic. We wish we could be celebrating with him today. Despite all the hardships we've undergone, we remain resilient. As a class, we have a habit of making the best out of the situations we are given. Not only do we survive hard situations, we thrive in those environments. And that is why we will continue to make history. Nelson Mandela once said, "Do not judge me by my success. Judge me by how many times I fell down and got back up again." Many times life will push us down, as we've experienced in our 4 years together. However, despite this, we kept getting up and accomplishing great things. It is hard to keep moving forward when adversity strikes, but the best way to get through tough times and to succeed is to turn your weaknesses into strengths. How do we do that? Well, class of 2020, I have a challenge for all of us. I challenge us to find that weakness and make it a mission to overcome it. Identify a physical, mental, or any other kind of weakness and push your limit every single day. If it's a physical challenge, you can do 100 pull-ups a day. If it's mental, you can read 50 pages of book a day. Whatever it is, set a tangible goal and make it your mission to complete it every single day, no matter what. There will be days where all you want to do is lay in your bed, watch The Bachelor, and go through an entire box of Cheez-Its. However, these are the days where completing your mission are most important. By doing something consistently that pushes you to improve, especially when you don't want to do it, your resilience to everything will grow. When your weakness becomes one of your strengths, move on to your next mission. This is how we keep moving forward through tough times. By building upon ourselves no matter what life throws at us. I believe we will climb out of these challenging times stronger than ever because of what we went through, not because it was easy. I think world-renowned poet Miley Cyrus said it best. "There's always going to be another mountain. I'm always going to want to make it move. Always going to be an uphill battle. Sometimes I'm going to have to lose." Life is not fair and is full of uncontrollable events. But no matter what situation you are in, two things you can always control are your attitude and your actions. Those will decide your success despite what life throws at you. So take the lessons you've learned here at OTHS and go into the world with confidence. You are men and women with missions. You cannot be stopped. I wish all of you the best. Thank you. Now I'll hand it off to Mr. Bickle to continue the ceremony.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Rich Bickle, principal of O'Fallon Township High School. Welcome to our 2020 commencement program. I would like to thank Braden for being such a wonderful senior class president and for the excellent introduction to the class of 2020. As Braden had said, we sadly lost classmate Dante Mercado this year. Please, let's honor Dante's memory now with a moment of silence. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, this morning, we celebrate the culmination of all the effort, all the hard work, and all the dedication of not only you very distinguished graduates, but also of your teachers, the staff, and most importantly, your parents and families who have supported, guided, and led you as you work toward the achievements you have earned. At OTHS, everyone has worked together to help the class of 2020 be successful, and at the same time, to help them become better prepared to face the many challenges of their futures. This effort includes everyone: teachers, counselors, social workers, coaches, administrators, nurses, paraprofessionals, computer and audiovisual support personnel, secretaries, custodians, the cafeteria staff, and of course, the community servants on the Board of Education. Each year, some of our graduates choose to enter military service. We would like to honor them at this time. Graduates, any of you who have enlisted or are already serving, please know that our admiration and gratitude are with you with each step that you take. Ladies and gentlemen, as we proceed through our ceremony, you will notice different colors of stoles that some of our graduates are wearing. Students wearing gold stoles are members of the National Honor Society, which recognizes students who have a cumulative grade point average of 3.500 or above. In addition to their gold stoles, students wearing red stoles are recognized as cum laude as a result of having achieved a cumulative grade point average between 3.800 and 3.899. Students wearing white stoles are recognized as magna cum laude as a result of having achieved a cumulative grade point average between 3.900 and 3.999. Students wearing green stoles are recognized as summa cum laude as a result of having achieved a cumulative grade point average of 4.0 or above. In addition, many of our students are wearing a variety of other cords, stoles, and medals that they earned through OTHS coursework and activities. Also very impressive are the number of college credits that have already been earned by our students in the class of 2020. Some of our students were part of the Southwestern Illinois College Running Start program and earned dual high school and college credits while completing coursework at Southwestern Illinois College for the past 2 years. Many of our students have earned dual high school and college credits through several colleges and universities through our course offerings here at OTHS and are preparing to enter college with the head start that those credits provide. Our congratulations go out to all of our students who have earned dual credit in these various ways. Students, we feel tremendously proud of your many accomplishments as OTHS graduates. We want to make sure that every student being recognized as a graduate in our ceremony this morning knows that we admire their effort and their accomplishments. So, graduates, no matter where your next steps are preparing to take you as you go forward from OTHS, know that we admire you. We are proud of you, and we will rejoice in your continued successes at the next stages of your lives. Graduates, as you do proceed to go forward from here, you do so in circumstances that are unique, with unique challenges and also unique opportunities. Challenges and opportunities often go hand in hand, and that will be a repeated reality throughout your lifetime. You have shown tremendous perseverance during this very unique time that we are living through together. You may have learned things during this time about yourself, about your strength, about your capabilities, about your mindset. You have shown resilience and creativity. You have chosen optimism, and you have created growth opportunities in the face of challenges. I'm reminded of a phrase that has been attributed to many over time. The phrase is, things turn out best for those who make the best of how things turn out. That phrase reminds us we will all have our moments of challenge and opportunity. And it helps us reflect on how we step into our moments. Class of 2020, you continue to inspire all of us with how you are stepping into your moment. All of us here at OTHS will long remember you and the unique moments in history that we have shared together. Congratulations to all of you being honored this morning, and congratulations to your parents and families. We are so proud of all of you. And now, ladies and gentlemen, let's enjoy this special presentation together as we recognize these fine students. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, as principal of O'Fallon Township High School, it's a great honor to certify that these students, the class of 2020, have met the graduation requirements as prescribed by the State of Illinois, the Illinois State Board of Education, and the Board of Education of District 203. Congratulations, graduates. At this time, students will now transfer their tassels from right to left to indicate their status as graduates. We have a tradition here at OTHS that is really quite a sight to behold. Class of 2020 graduates, your hats! Class of 2020, once again, congratulations and good luck to you. Know that our very best wishes are always with you.